So guess who is with me? Sam, you all know this face right here.
Hi.
Of course, we have a special. Yeah, we have a special guest.
She's coming. You'll see a little doll
right there.
You know, show your face. Look at this.
So fluffy. She's so fluffy in person. So cute. But we have a Poke Works and Kung Fu Tea mukbang for you, and we're gonna go through some of the questions on the vloggers, ultimate vloggers tag. So while we're eating and, you know, catching up, I haven't seen this girl in like forever.
8 months maybe?
Yeah,
something
yeah,
like that.
It's been a long time. So, and now I can call her Mrs. Robinson.
I know, I got married.
Long time, lots of
catch up about.
So yeah, okay girl. Let's
she
eat
loves her
like
now.
Start. Oh, good.
She wouldn't know that she didn't love her like 5 minutes
but
ago.
But I gave her a lot of treats. That's like the ultimate way to win a
dogs doggy. Love it when you film too.
For really?
Yeah, they're like, hey, let me get in the.
She knows.
Camera. Okay, you gotta back up now. Time to eat.
She's like,
back it up.
She has no personal space.
Dogs never know personal space.
But,
what did you get to drink?
I got the large winter melon milk tea. Ooh. Oh, actually, let me do a close-up shot.
So you guys
too.
Can see what we're eating.
Yeah. Money shot.
I'm watching you, you know.
Here is the up close.
Don't come from this angle.
Of the poke bowl. So Sam got the poke bowl, mm-hmm. and I got the poke salad.
Ah,
so there's a whole bunch of
shrimp
in them. I do. I have shrimp and salmon and like the crab salad. Just a whole bunch. You had a lot of stuff too.
Mm-hmm. I salmon and tuna.
And then we got the Kung Fu, the melon milk tea.
And I have the milk green tea.
Yes. Alright, time to dig in. So I have the questions all set on my phone. Let's see.
It says for best taste consumed within 2 hours.
Oh, yes.
I've never seen that before.
It's been like less around there.
Oh, it'll be fine.
Mm-hmm.
You know, your personal space.
Personal space. So, Sam's like the ultimate guru in poke bowls.
I am.
Seriously, like every time I see her snaps, every time I see her snap, she's always like eating her poke bowl.
I am.
In California. And I'm so glad it's actually slowly filtering into the East Coast. You wanna sit?
You're gonna get kicked out now.
You wanna
sit? You're so nosy.
So yeah, we're so excited. Oh, daddy's calling you.
Go daddy, come on. go daddy. One second, guys.
One second. So I'll just start mixing my bowl.
She's like, wait, I just got played.
Oh, she wants to come back in.
She breaks through this door. She's determined for some poke works.
So I guess you guys want to know, how does it feel to be Mrs. Robinson?
Oh, yeah. So I got married on paper.
Yeah.
In December. So it's been like 5 months now?
Like time flies.
It does. It really
Seriously.
Does. And we're having our ceremony. It's April now. We're having it next April.
Oh.
Mel will be there.
Spring wedding.
I should just hand you the invitation while you're here. But
do you have it?
I do. I do have the invitation envelopes. The problem was, see, I haven't sent out my stuff. I'm one of those like early bird type of people. I've like planned it all.
Yeah.
But it's so far away that you're like.
He reached out to me and was like, Mel.
Yeah, I was like, hey, what's your rates? You know, I'm just, you know, checking out everyone in the area's rates because I have a whole year to like run numbers. I'm just that type of person.
I was like, wow, you're like so on top of things.
Yeah, I think because I like to plan ahead financially. You know, I just want to plan ahead, kind of like, when is your deposit due? When is your deposit due? So you're not like, oh my god, overwhelmed. I think that's where the stress from wedding planning comes.
That makes so much sense because you guys should have be on like, you know.
On a schedule for it. You know, like this paycheck's gonna go to this. And this paycheck's gonna go to that. Because everything, like, even venue deposits.
Right.
It's at the end.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you have the one in the beginning and then the 3 months before the wedding,
right.
1 week before the wedding, it will get on top of you. So I put it in my planner, this is due then, this is due then. So I don't get
overwhelmed. Do you consider yourself to have a type A personality?
Oh, I'm so type A. I run to my family. My sister is worse than me. And she's my maid of honor.
There you go. So we know that this is going to be a very organized wedding.
Oh, yeah. Half of it probably won't even be organized by me. Kelly's also one of my bridesmaids, and she's kind of type A, too.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to... Actually, all of my bridesmaids are type A.
I can't wait to meet her because I actually never met her.
It's like the out of town best friend problem. Yeah, yeah. So you always miss each other at like certain events.
Right. Always. Yeah.
Yeah. See each other more out of town than we do in town. It's very sad.
It's almost like, Sam, are you gonna be at this event?
He's like, no, yes. I'm at home. And then you're like, I'm at home when I'm out there. It's always that case. Yeah. We just missed each other by like 3 days in New York.
Yeah. Yeah. Crazy.
Did you drive up?
I did drive up.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, because you're going for your family.
Well, it was funny because also that same weekend, right after my sister's baby shower, I went straight to Phoenix. Like, I drove back to BWI and then took the flight from there.
Was it a wedding or?
For a blogger's trip.
That's
fun. So it was fun because I had never been to Phoenix. So it was nice to like go and explore. Mm-hmm. Literally, I want to go back. It was just the most awesome place. Like, I feel like you could really eat very clean.
I heard it's very good there.
And it's so, and like people love like outdoorsy stuff and health conscious. And even the farms are, they even treat their like chickies as their own, you know, like that's so beef type. Like, it's nice to see that because I was almost getting to a point where like I lost faith in the farm industry, you know, and I'm sure it's still happening a lot more, but at least I can see
some
are still holding its integrity, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah.
It just depends on what area you're in.
Mm-hmm. All right. So let's start with the first question. On the blogger's tag. Mm-hmm. Oh, sorry, the vlogger's tag.
Same thing.
And it was, when was your first vlog? I actually have to think about this too.
I know.
You so know I, exactly?
I know exactly.
Wow.
So I'm running on my 8-year anniversary in 2 weeks on YouTube. So I know that. It's about around like May, like the first 10 days of May. I can't say exactly, but 8 years ago. So that's 2009. That's when I.
2009 was your first vlog.
May 2009.
Do you count beauty vlogs or do you count?
That was my first video ever posted.
Okay.
Like in my life.
I don't know if that's like a vlog, like what they're saying, like a actual vlog.
What does that count?
Does it count?
I think vlogs is like a video vlog. All right. If it's like daily vlog, I probably started in like 2010. Very close by.
Yeah, I think I started around the same time too, like 2009. Mm-hmm. And I've been like very inconsistent with it though, because it's like. Work comes into play, and then
adult
life just comes into play. So I have a lot of like gaps in between my stuff. But I always say like 2009, and it also said like when's your first? What was your first vlog? What was the video?
Mine was a welcome to my channel type of video. It was like I have no clue what I'm doing type of like talking segment, but this is what I'm gonna try to do. And thanks for like you know viewing.
Yeah.
It was only like on my webcam. Good old days.
The good old days.
Before all this happened, you know.
Right, and then we have all this equipment to make us look like flawless.
Too much work. Too much work.
I remember exactly what mine was, but it's no longer on the channel anymore, but it was
mine. Yeah. Your first video never ends up, quality changes, you gotta take it down.
It was of a hair, like a very simple hairstyle that I put together. I didn't even talk at all. I don't even think I looked at the camera once. It was just like...
Well, you have to train yourself.
Yeah, it was just hard. Like, you know, and I just like posted up. Because at the time I was looking for videos, I was looking for updos and there were barely any updo videos.
Male kicks butt updos.
So that's why I decided to put like my first one up.
You found the niche.
I did.
Like a common story. It's the I couldn't find any, so I decided to do it with a lot of businesses in general.
I was looking for an updo for my best friend's wedding, and I did my own. But yeah, I put that up, and here we are. Mm-hmm. And I love that the thing about YouTube, and the reason why I keep coming back is just like you know the people I meet, my friends. Most of my friends like I met. In some way connected social media wise, and I love that because otherwise you would actually you know have to bump into them in the conventional
sense. Naturally are a little bit less social without YouTube. We're more social. It pushes you a little out of your comfort zone, and it actually makes it your comfort zone now, which is kind of cool.
Yeah. So I'm so glad, and like all these events bring everyone together, and that's how we like even met other people.
Let's be honest, half of us went there because we heard there was free stuff, but then we realized it's so fun to hang out with each other. So now we kind of go half and half. We don't care as much anymore.
Because who doesn't love free stuff, right?
That's the human nature, free stuff.
Okay.
What's next?
The next one is...
So we did one and two.
Three is share in chronological order your vlogging cameras over time.
Oh, shoot.
That's like really hard because I must have changed cameras so often. Mm-hmm. But one thing for sure I know
is that... You're a photographer, too. That's not fair.
But one thing for sure, I definitely kept within the Canon line. So my first camera would probably be like the one, I think it was like at least the something S100 or something where it's just like a straight arm. Yeah,
point and shoot.
No like flip camera.
Flips didn't happen until like within 3 years
ago.
This is the whole thing.
That was a straight arm where you have to like put it on in front of you and then a mirror behind you. And then, you know, you gotta see like...
It's like on a box, up, like otherwise it's down here.
How you do it? That's like the budget.
You either stack the box or you sat lower. You sat on the floor, which is what we're doing right now.
And then after that was like, I don't know, I just kept changing and I really can't remember, but I know it was like Canon something black. It was all black
was the thing then. Yeah. Now white cameras are the thing now. A lot of people, I still have all black. Mm-hmm. But a lot of people now, like Sony came out with whites and everyone has the same camera.
Yeah,
it's kind of refreshing that you have a different camera right now because everyone has the same.
I'm trying this camera out. It is the M6. It's a mirrorless camera, and I'm trying it for my travel camera as well as my YouTube camera. It's not heavy. It's only heavy if you add the lens. So right now I have like, that's the whole reason why I got that one.
That's nice.
So before that was the G7X that you guys saw me talk about.
I'm super excited to see this video now. I want to see the quality.
Yeah, I hope they were in focus.
That's
not key. Here, I'm going to have to double check.
Okay, I'll just stay right here.
Okay.
We're good.
Wait.
Are we good?
Yeah. I just want to double check that we're in focus the whole
time. It's hard because at a certain distance, guys, we can't see anymore.
Yeah.
We can see what you see, but we can't see if we're clear.
Oh, you know what, though? It would help if connected by, like, the laptop so you can see.
Yeah, I don't
the
laptop.
I didn't... I mean, I'm just saying that when it's this far,
You put on a good
monitor on the side, too, so you just, like,
we're not doing the mirror days anymore.
We're not that proud right now. I'm not kidding. So, yeah. So then I decided to go into like the Rebel. So it was the Rebel
T3i.
I got the T4i.
Okay.
So I got the T4i because of its automatic focus, but that didn't really work because it's only like it does autofocus enough, but you can also hear the lens.
Wow.
Yeah, it's pretty loud. So even with this one, you can hear the lens move and everything, and I haven't gotten myself to get the 7D, and I think that's what you have, right?
I have the 70D.
Yeah, 70D. So I haven't, like, you know, I looked into that, but it's just like I can't
justify.
You have the Mark. I do.
5D?
5D Mark III, but that's not autofocus.
Mm-hmm. It's so good for photography or someone shooting for you.
Yeah.
Great.
So I don't, can't justify me buying the 7D yet, so we'll see. Yeah.
It's usually like one or the other.
Yeah.
I only know like two people. Yo, Whaley has both.
Mm-hmm.
But Wah shoots her with the 5D.
Mm-hmm.
And she said the 70D is good when she's shooting solo.
Yeah.
You know? I've had the 70D for 3 years now. Mm-hmm. I can't believe it. And I haven't switched off it. It's like I don't have a reason because I know the 80D. I don't see the point.
There's no point unless you like, I mean, if it does everything.
I tried
that
the 70, it didn't work for me for my shooting style. And I had it for a week, then I bought that one.
Mm.
And it's been good for me. It broke once last year.
Uh-oh.
Last year I had like supposedly bad luck according to whatever Asian horoscopes or whatever.
Really,
my mom's birthday year, she was like 92, bad year. I had the worst year ever last year. I got bags lost, I missed flights. I had the worst luck, cars broke. You know, like everything that could have gone wrong went wrong, and then my camera, I've never broken a camera, bro.
Whoa,
it wouldn't turn on.
I wouldn't say last year was like really, really that bad, but I guess I could see it because
it's based off your birth year, supposedly.
Well, I mean, like the first year was like my divorce finalized, right? Mm-hmm. So that was January, but then and then March when we had Jenny's wedding, my car got broken.
Your camera got stolen.
I had two bodies, two 5D Mark III. That's the second one.
That's a mortgage there, right? Guys, that's a really serious mortgage.
It was
stolen from
it
you.
Hurt me so bad.
I saw a mail the next day. It was so it was
sad. It was so hurtful. But
we were both there for the wedding.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, what?
Uh-huh. And then, like, and then I guess, like, in between that time, nothing happened. Then at the end, it, you know, I lost my job. So it was like, I don't know if that I should see that.
It's like a rough year.
It was, oh, yeah. And then, like, and then Trump's election. So
it was probably a rough year
for a lot of us.
Only a few. Can I ask you at the end of the year, ask my followers, like, how was your year? I would say at least 70%
people say the same thing.
They were like, it was a bad year. A few people had, like, they got married and stuff and had good years. And of course, not everyone can have a bad year. But I was like, man, the majority was not having it. But yeah. I would recommend the Canon 70D. It's been good to me. I don't know why it turned off, but it was it costed a pretty penny to fix
it. Oh, that sucks.
Canon warranties.
Yeah. So now I sold the T4i, and now I have this one, which is the M6. So cool. I've been testing it out, and so far I think the quality's been okay.
Do you have a lenses for it?
That's
the base one.
Mm-mm. This is my regular my lens that I use for photography.
Yeah. Is there a conversion kit on it?
Yes.
Cool.
So I got an adapter that changes for the M lens to an EF or EFS lens.
I like how a lot of these cameras do that. Even Sony's have Canon conversion lens kits. That's cool. Wasn't like that before.
So what was yours?
I started with the MacBook Pro webcam. That's how I started.
Classic, yo.
That's very classic. And then people started, you know, stepping up their game. I went straight to a camcorder. I went to a Canon camcorder.
Oh, yeah.
I liked it for a while. I mean, it was good to have a remote. Mm-hmm. It was good when you were learning to film yourself and autofocus. You could see yourself focus. That was before the T3i came out, and everyone was doing T3i. But I never switched because of the focus issue. T4i wasn't out yet. T5 out didn't come yet. I had a Rebel. I don't remember what it was, but it was for only photography. It didn't film. That was, the first Rebel that came out. It didn't film yet. So I was like, okay, I have something for pictures. I have something that films. Stayed like that for a couple years. Then I got this camera, my 70D. And it's been my beauty camera, steady. As far as vlog camera goes, I've switched around. I stayed Canon only. I was really loyal to Canon.
Yeah.
But then mine, I had one of those point and shoots too. It made a weird clicky noise. And it had a lot of background noise, movement noise. The mic wasn't great on it. Mm-hmm. So I switched to Sony vlog cameras. So I've been very loyal to the Sony RX100 line.
I heard that's a pretty good camera.
I had the Mark 1, the Mark 2, I'm on the Mark 3 right now. They've already released the Mark 5, but I haven't gone there. I don't know. See, I'm looking into the Sony, what are they called? A7s. I'm looking at the A7s, but those are pretty petty. So I think my
friend has that.
It's like a $3,000 camera.
But I think that's part of the reason why I decided to switch from the G7X, which I didn't have for long. I maybe had that for 3 months.
People love that.
Yeah, and it was the G7X Mark II, so it was even the newer version. But because I have lenses that I can change,
having it's more bang for your buck.
Yeah. So for me, having a camera that can change lenses was more beneficial to me. And it was also because of my friend when we went to Iceland. Mm-hmm. She shot was on her Sony. I don't know. I think it has to be the A7 or
it's
something.
A7R. It's one of them. But they're good. The beautiful outfits.
It was beautiful photos, and you know you can change your lens. So to me, I felt like this was more versatile for me.
That's my next step.
Yeah,
it's smaller than a big DSLR.
Yeah, and because I travel and I also shoot outfits when I travel, I wanted to find something that I can carry with me, because the 5D Mark III.
Oh, I would have a heart attack if I carried the 5D around. It's heavy as crap, and if you drop it, it's like breaking your heart. At least it's the A7 is an in between of a point and shoot and a DSLR. Right?
Yeah.
It's like, what are they called now? Like compact cameras or something like that? I don't know what they're called. But it's like the mid size, and that's what everyone's switching to now, just for versatility and usage, bang for your buck. But they're so expensive because they're worth it, I've heard.
Yeah.
But yeah, so now I'm at the Sony RX Mark III. I'm not gonna get the Mark IV because to me it's not worth it. They come up with it's one of those when you get a good one, and then when they start just making a new one because it shoots in 4K. I don't need that yet on my vlog camera.
All of it is very marketing.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm sure they had all of this technology back then, but they really just
It's like the iPhone 7. It wasn't that different.
Do you really need that camera? Do you really need that phone? You have to think about what's
What does it do for you? What do you, what are your
needs? What is your needs? Because a lot of people are like,
would have been the same thing.
Snapchatted me, asked me if like the ADD is worth it, and I was like, not from what I've read. I've read reviews, so there's plenty of like photography sites that compare cameras for you, and I was like, for me, there's nothing that I would need to switch for. And I'm like, but if you can get it at a good deal, because some people, you don't find good deals, I'm like, yeah, go ahead if you don't have another camera that's similar.
Yeah.
You know, but for us, we have a whole wall, we have a, we just told you a story about how much we have, you know? So we're not normal people.
The life of a vlogger.
Okay. The last question, oh no. What do you use to edit your vlogs? Number four.
What do you use?
I started with, you know, Windows Movie Maker.
My first video was Windows Movie Maker. I did one on that, never did it again.
What?
It's a lot. 8 hours to save. My Toshiba laptop couldn't handle it. It was broken.
I must have used that for a good first 3 or 4 years.
It's hard. I give you props for that.
Well, it's not fancy editing. Like, if you're not, you're just cutting frames, but nothing else.
It's hard to teach yourself on those.
Yeah,
it's definitely not.
Because I tried to go into a Mac store and I
was trying to use iMovie.
Yeah, I thought that was hard.
It's when you're used to Windows.
Yeah, I think it's like a lot of dragging.
Well, Windows laptops have that click button instead of like the MacBook trackpad has no buttons. The whole trackpad is the button. You have to get used to that.
I thought it was so difficult.
Zoom and the scroll is hard. Like,
but and then after that, like, I still stuck with PC, so I did the Adobe Premiere.
I
used that, and I, you know, I learned that and everything. But then after a while, two or three years ago, I went to a MacBook
Pro.
And then, yeah, the MacBook Pro. And then I started using Final Cut Pro.
I did one thing on Windows Movie Maker. My laptop, like I said, couldn't handle it. It literally broke, so I had to buy a MacBook the next week. So that's like my second video, and from then on was always a MacBook, edited and filmed. My parents, thank you, Mom and Dad, bought me a MacBook. I was like, I need it, because my laptop just broke. The motherboard broke for some reason. But, so I was on iMovie for maybe like 4 years, and then a Final Cut came out.
Yeah.
I tried, failed at that for about a year and a half. Now I use Final Cut, I would say, 80% of the time. I still cut movies in iMovie just because for me, because I did it for 4 years, I can
easier.
Yeah, for 5 minutes, I can get everything just like rough cut in, then I do everything else in Final Cut. And there's like a button that says send movie to Final Cut.
Oh, yeah, I didn't know
it's
that.
It's under file. Mm. If you hit file, it's a send movie to Final Cut, and anything you just did moves all over, and then finish it there.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're already trained in iMovie, and it's already on your computer, you can do that. But yeah, I've only used Final Cut now, and I add a bunch of, you know, extra packs to it. I buy the little $10 packs for text effects and all that.
Me too.
Yeah. And it works. It doesn't fail me. The one time it failed me was when, you know, it closes on you, you lose all your footage. It happens. You get used to
that
it.
That is a work.
They update it. It's okay.
After you've gone through all like the edits or like the
you cry.
Another hour of wasted.
The top three things that are the worst things: mic not on, camera not in focus.
You
editor
know what?
Crashes on you.
I still don't use them. Like, I still don't have an external mic.
Good.
I still use, like, whatever's
well,
on.
Well, with the 70D, you'd have to.
Really? Is it that bad?
It's not clear enough. It's worth it. But if you were filming a lookbook, you're fine.
Yeah. I haven't been upgraded to the beauty light yet, guys. I'm really
impressed
with
it. Well, it's because you had a adult life to handle first, you know?
And I usually like to shoot in the daylight, but today,
it's raining.
It is completely, like, raining.
Overcast.
Cloudy. And then my face is going through like a dry space.
You're far enough they can't see.
So then I was like, I need light to drown out my flaws.
I got you. I thought that last year.
Really?
And for someone who's been doing it 8 years, I'm so late to the game. But yeah, I waited until the LED one came out.
Yeah, because like, I sometimes shoot in the loft area, so I always have light coming this way. But there's no light coming this way, so you want to like, drown, you know, you want to fill the light here, make it even.
Mm-hmm. I have my light.
You
side
guys.
Light. Backlight.
This is like the things that we do. You know?
You have no clue right now, like how exhausting it is.
People say it's easy, you know, to make a YouTube video.
No, they say it's not a real job.
Oh, they say it's not a real job, right? So, yeah, granted, it might not be a real conventional job.
Traditional.
But like the thing is like we put these same amount of time and energy into making a video. For example, I would, you know, if I'm doing a hairstyle, I have to think, okay, I want to do like 5 types of hairstyles. So I have to research what are the 5 types that I need to do. So I make a note, and then I actually have to set time aside to film it, and then get the material together if there's extra material to film it. Literally, you spend like, what is that? There's like the behind the stage stuff that you don't see.
And you turn your house
that's
into
4 hours already. Yeah, and then like an additional, you know, 2 to 3 hours to clean and then to edit to like, that's 8 hours. I have caught myself, like counted one video before what took me a whole 8 hours. That is a day's job.
Different from the traditional job, which I'm sure you can agree. You know when the day's over because you know when you're going home.
Yeah, but with
this, you don't get to go home. You're already home.
A lot of the creative stuff that you guys see,
it's so much harder to turn it off.
Yeah, it's hard to turn off, and there needs to be like a, you know, a life constant, balance kind of thing. But literally, some of us do work through the night, especially if I do have a full-time
job. Some people
are
more night people too.
Yeah, I have to do my day job and then like, you know, YouTube, and that's why you see a lot of times I don't.
And then you're like, I'm done, but it's 4 a.m.
Yeah,
who's gonna watch this if I post it right now? If I post it, I probably missed something.
Oh my gosh, I'm so glad that they did the schedule part, because that really
so
helped.
Much better.
Yeah. I never thought about the upload time, because
I just upload now. The internet's faster now, but when we first started, remember it used to take hours.
Oh my god, the DSL, or like the DSL, right? Or the
dial up.
Thank God, I think I was passing.
I was asking that too.
If I could dial up, it would have been like freaking like 3 days.
You have to give props to like Michelle Fonda. They did it in the dial-up time.
Oh my god.
Like at the end of the dial-up time.
That's why I don't understand why it took so long to upload a video. Now I know. The files get bigger and bigger and bigger.
No fiber optics. Everything was real hard to do, guys. Parents would have killed you if you held up that long. What's the last question?
All right, last question was, share 3 of your favorite bloggers to watch.
Are we like, is any vlog, any YouTubers at this point?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
Well, I watch a lot, but
who doesn't?
Mainly, I think lately I've just been watching my friends.
Mm-hmm.
Sam, I obviously watch hers. KL, hey girl.
Oh yeah.
So I always watch hers. Michelle Bell.
Mm-hmm.
Was it
21? I don't know the number.
21, I think. Michelle Bell, 21.
It's a 20.
Yeah.
It's a 20.
I watch her because like I know, like, you know, I met her in person and everything. And a lot of times I just watch the people that pretty much I met in person.
Well, it's almost like catching up with your friends.
It really is.
When you're watching it. It's like typing almost.
Okay. Yeah, and now that now KL's doing like you now, so now I get to see her like whenever she, you know, streams.
Yeah.
So that's awesome. I know I've
KL's hair is looking really good.
It's so cute. Unicorn colors.
The cut is so
ethereal.
Cute.
It is so cute. And then like I think those 3 like top, but then I've also been watching a lot of mukbangs. Hence the stuff that you've been seeing on my channel. Like a lot of mukbangs, and it's just been weird watching that. But yeah.
That's so hard for me. See, I haven't really been watching YouTubers per se, because everyone's actually uploading a little slower.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe slower weather, maybe everyone has stuff going on in their lives, so I'm not mad when people don't upload. I've been catching up with TV shows on YouTube. You know how they have the channels? Like, you watch The Real?
No.
It's kind of like The View, but they have a channel, so if I don't see the episodes, I just catch up on their channels and stuff like that. So I've been doing a lot of that, some Wendy Williams, my gossip love. It's just fun to watch, but
pleasure.
It's like I keep it on and do my face.
I do that a lot.
It just runs. Yeah. The playlist runs.
Yeah.
So that's cool. For YouTubers, I've been watching Juan Whaley's channel, Wally TV, a lot, because they post nice long, like, over 15-minute vlogs. I can, like, really, like, enjoy folding my laundry, you know. Something I don't have to get up and change every, like, few minutes. I've been doing that. I've been doing Kelly, of course. It's just Kelly. Mm-hmm. She does the same thing. Thank you for the long videos, girl. It's like catching up with her when I can't FaceTime with her. I'm like, oh, what are you doing? And I hate it when I'm not caught up in my friends' lives, because then when you see them, you're almost like, what have you been doing? And everyone in the world knows what they've been doing the past few months, except for you. You feel like a horrible friend. You know, like, if my friends post a gender reveal, like April's having another baby boy. Mm-hmm. If she posts one and I don't know what it is, but the whole world knows if it's a girl or a boy, I feel horrible. So I've been catching up with everyone's vlogs, like Judy's and April's, just daily vloggers, who aren't so daily anymore, luckily. So I can, like,
how long have they gone down to?
Judy, I think, just does, like, 1 or 2 less a week.
Okay.
So she groups maybe, like, 2,
2 days together. And it's like, just, you know, because the kids are getting older and, you know, life's getting busier. So that's good. And I think it's healthy. I think it's healthy to, they've been doing it for like so many years straight that you need a break.
Everyone, I was going to say, your life has been on camera the day.
It strains you. And a lot of people, you know, since like the prank versus prank people broke up and it was like such a thing, like, I think people are taking their lives more seriously, which I can appreciate a lot. April and Justin, I think, went down a day or two as well because they're also having another baby and, you know, life got busy. Justin has his like own, like, you know, trending family work stuff, and I'm happy that everyone's happy. Do whatever you need to do, you know. I hate the I have to do, because you know the guilt when you haven't uploaded in a long time. You feel so bad, but you can't anymore. You just can't. You gotta take time for yourself.
And then when you don't, when you haven't uploaded in so long too, it's like, for me, like, I do have to get into the mood.
You get a rut.
And then, like, you have to get into the mood, and then the, you know, the weather changes on you, so there's that. And then when you're in the mood, the weather changes.
You might have your period, and now you're not in the mood. It's life.
But now I think about it too, it's like, you know, if I want things to be done, I have to do it. Like, I can't just like sit around and just
this job is a self-motivating
that, yeah, like, think that is gonna happen, because no content's gonna be out there until you make it happen. So and for people, I guess, like, tips for people who want to start a channel, it is a lot harder to build your channel lately. But
oh, because YouTube's on this thing they call YouTube death, the death of YouTube right now. So dramatic, guys. But so, like, it's a hard time.
Yeah, so if you do want to do it out of the pure, like, appreciation and, you know,
your own joy,
happiness that you're making these videos for other people. Don't do it for, you know, for the money. Don't do it for the fame.
I hate the fame.
Don't do it for any of that, because it's not worth it, you know?
Not at all.
Yeah.
I was recently just, like, talking to my husband Chris about it. I was like, I kind of appreciate back in the day where you had to apply to be a partner. Because it weeded out these people who just make these stupid viral videos of, like, pranking their children to the point that it's almost detrimental to their children or something like that. Or, like, you know, just fake videos where you're just like, now it's just because anyone can make money, but before, you had to be approved. Your content had to be reviewed and approved. And we weren't held to such strict guidelines. Now it's different.
I don't even know if you know, like, back then when I started my channel,
you had to scroll to the bottom, hit partner, and hit apply.
Like, I had, and this was not my first, you know, channel. LaBelleMel31 was my first channel. Yeah. I had to switch from that because in the beginning I was using music and, you know,
copyright issues.
Black. So I just felt like, you know what?
Clean slate.
Yeah, a clean slate, because I did apply for partner at that channel and I couldn't get it. So I was like thinking, clean slate, you know, and then I was just letting my EPS people in.
Oh, the buzz.
Yeah. So it was like, clean slate, new channel, you know. So that's what happened. Then after a few months, then I applied again. But it literally took me like at least 2 or 3 times to apply for partner. And then now people can just get it for, like,
it doesn't matter how old you are, which is great. And I feel like it has its upside of now people, it's open to everyone. And, like, you know, you don't have to stress about, like, you know, some people always ask us, how do you become famous? You can do what you want now. And if people watch you, people watch you. But at the same time, it's kind of detrimental because some people just want the fame. They just want the money. It's like the how about that girl.
Yeah. You know? And then now people are
doing... And it's fake.
Right. Because like, people are doing like more clickbait videos too. Which I never thought that was... something.
The fact that you can put "not clickbait" in the title now is a problem. You know, like, I bought a new car, not clickbait.
Yeah, like, and I was like, that's a thing now.
It kind of kills it for the people who actually have a passion for this, because all the advertising and views, all the advertisers on YouTube are going away now.
Yeah, that's what I heard. They're pulling out of.
That's why people are. That's the death of YouTube, because the content on there is violent or offensive or crude. Or just stuff the company doesn't want to be associated with.
I thought that you could actually adjust the ads, whatever type
YouTube
of ads.
YouTube needs to kind of, on the backside of it, technically fix some things to keep them going the way they used to be going. Because advertisers don't feel safe anymore. And that's sad, because it used to be a safer place, as safe as the internet could be.
Yeah.
But now it's like, you can't put a Pampers ad over a kid prank video. It's just kind of weird, you know?
Yeah.
That's what's happening in the world right now. We got drama at our workplace, and we don't even have a workplace. We're home.
Instead, it's on the interweb.
Yep.
You know, drama and interweb that
we have a lot of gossip to catch up with after this.
Oh, yeah. I can't wait.
Behind the scenes. Well, thank you for having me on your channel.
Of course.
And for the food run.
Yeah. It was...
Sam's moving further and further away from me.
Blame the real estate prices.
It's making it so much harder to get together. I think it's...
Well, I see you in New York and LA anyway.
Yeah, I'm always jetting off to places anyway.
Wanderlust.
Yeah, right. Oh, I'm totally on that kick, so...
You have to explain that to me. I have no clue what wanderlust.
I think it's just one of those where it's like, now I'm kind of evolving my channel. It was like a lot of beauty. I added fashion.
You feel freedom now? As far as content goes?
Yeah, like I feel like it's my channel, I can, you know, I can evolve as I evolve, you know. I'm very much into traveling and I want to showcase more
of my travel vlogs.
And I think that's how, like, the channel that you make is should grow organically, you know, how you are. Because you're not going to be the same person 10 years ago or 8 years ago or even 2 years ago, you know?
If I'm still doing this in 10 years, I'm like... turning 35, I'm gonna be like such a different person than when I was 16.
Yeah,
I swear to God, if I'm the same person, you guys
you
need to call somebody.
Change is constant, guys. Like you can't be the same.
You've changed. But yeah, I better have. That means
she better have changed. Like we all have to change because that's how we learn and grow to be who we are today. So
for better or for worse, if you really like to watch her, you'll still like to watch her, no matter if she's posting about food or travel or. Animals.
Oh, my Dexie.
So do you make videos of Dex?
I show him a lot on my video. Or at least I show him like up close. And I know, like, I don't know if people would like to see him.
Who cares? You like
He's
it.
He's just so cute. But yeah, but thank you so much for being on my channel.
I'm honored.
And I'm so glad we got to eat some yummies. Because, you know, usually when we get together, we just eat anyway. So
that's the whole point of it.
Might as well just, like, show you guys what we normally do anyways.
Hope you guys enjoyed watching us eat and talk. Sorry if I chewed with my mouth open, but
I think that's the whole point of mukbang.
Yeah, I mean...
apparently, the louder you chew, the more that they laugh. Because you have to make it
I've been complimenting people for years.
I love the way you chew. So thank you so much. Until next time, I'm sure we'll be in other videos in the future.
I'm sure.
Bye-bye.